2022 is almost behind us, and for movie buffs, it's a chance to look back at all the releases this past year. You can binge some of your favorites and bookmark your calendar for what's still to come in the new year. And today, we are taking a look back at this year in Hollywood, both on the big and the small screens. So, of course, back with us now is Tom Santilli, film critic and co-host and executive producer of Movie Show Plus. Tom, this is exciting. We get to talk about all the great stuff that we just experienced over what was really an incredible year. So let's get to it. What were some of your favorites this year?
Yeah, this is my favorite time of year for movies because I get to talk about what my favorite films of the year were. I just posted my list on movieshowplus.com of my top 20 films of the year, so you could go check that out. But today, I'm going to highlight my top five, starting with my number five film. That movie is Guillermo del Toro's Pinocchio. I was so blown away by this movie. You know, you think the story of Pinocchio is about a wooden puppet that's trying to be a boy. Guillermo del Toro spins this into a father's story. This is about Geppetto and his love and loss and learning to be a father. That struck me. I have a six-year-old. Plus, this movie was just so incredibly made. It took him over 10 years, painstaking, stop-motion animation. Just beautiful, beautiful film, and knocked my socks off. It's on Netflix. Number four on my list is The Fabelmans. This is a movie from Steven Spielberg. It's autobiographical about his own upbringing. But it's not just a movie about movies. It's a movie about how movies affect us in the different ways that movies can infect our lives and even heal us. I just thought this was a beautiful film from the best filmmaker of all time. Number three on the list was sadly overlooked at the box office. It's a movie called Bros. This was my funniest film of the year. Just a great rom-com. Not since When Harry Met Sally, and I definitely use that comparison with caution.
Wow.
But when Harry Met Sally, this movie, the words jump off the screen. They had so much to say, and it just such a really funny, poignant movie. And I really hope people find this film. Number two on the list is in theaters now. It's Babylon. This is a movie from Damien Chazelle. This was a crazy, wild, outrageous film. It might not be for everybody, but I felt like this movie had a lot to say and was just a brilliant masterpiece by a guy who I loved all his films, La La Land, Whiplash, First Man. And so Babylon is my number two film.
Number one, Kevin? I don't know. Hang on, let me sit back. All right, I'm ready for number one. What is it?
Yeah, get on the edge of your seat or fall back in your seat, whatever works for you. Number one for me, Top Gun Maverick. Should come as no surprise.
Yes.
This movie checked all the boxes for me. It was amazing. It was cool. It brought you back. It brought you forward. And it's also, from a cinematic perspective, just really an astounding achievement. Sound, cinematography. Tom Cruise is the biggest movie star of all time, and this movie just worked. And there was no better movie-going experience to me in 2022 than Top Gun Maverick.
And I'm so bummed I didn't get to see it in IMAX. Like, I really wanted to see it. It's probably going to go back at some point, right? Because the movie did so well. I don't know. Maybe they'll put it back in the theaters.
I think it'll get an Oscar. It's going to get some Oscar nominations, I think. And when it does, I'm sure they'll re-release it to kind of get as much as they can, especially with Avatar Way of Water on its tail at the
box
office.
Right, yeah. Yeah, sir, I don't know why I went backward in my seat. You're supposed to go forward, so it's just...
for me, I'll take whatever. Any movement shows me that you're... Yeah.
Well, speaking of going forward, what do you think that's in store for the new year now? I mean, are we totally behind sort of the COVID issues with movie theaters and how movies are made and presented and delivered? What do you think is next for us in 2023?
We're still, 2022 was a rebound year for the movie theaters. We showed that people still love to go to the movie theater. Top Gun Maverick, we talked about Avatar at the end of the year, the Batman. But overall, Hollywood released about 40 less movies than prior to the pandemic. It's still that middle gap. All the movies in the middle are kind of disappearing. So 2023 will be another year where hopefully people get out to the theater to watch those rom-coms like Bros or the family movies. Disney had two bombs this year, Strange Things and Lightyear. Yeah. So it's kind of, you never quite know what's going to hit with today's audience.
We hope new ones are coming out. And real quickly, because we're out of time here, but we want to talk about the special surprise you have for our viewers. What do you have for us today, Tom?
Yeah, go to the link on your screen for a chance to win some free tickets to Babylon. It's in theaters now. It's my number two movie of the year. And I hope you just go there and you'll get some instructions on how you can score some free tickets to Babylon.
All right, free tickets. We love it. Movieshowplus.com. Tom Santilli, everybody. Hey, happy new year, Tom. Thanks so much. We'll see you again in the new year.
Happy new year. Thank you, everybody out there. And we'll see you at the movies in 2023.
All right, we'll be right back.
It's the holiday.